What is going on, guys? It's Modded Dwarf here. Welcome back to another PS4 tutorial. So in this tutorial, I'm going to be covering how you can play online on your Jailbroken PS4 using Hamachi. So this is nothing like PSN, just to set expectations right away here. Unfortunately, you can only play with a handful of people and on a select number of titles. Any title that supports LAN play, you should be able to play online with. So the way this works is that Sleirsgoevy took Hamachi and ported it into a homebrew app that you can run directly on the PS4. This makes it a lot easier to set up than something like Xlink Kai or XBS Link, which I've covered in previous tutorials. The big advantage of those services is that you can also use, you know, retail PS4s to connect to people who are on jailbroken PS4s and vice versa with those services, but they are a lot more complicated to set up, whereas this will only really work with jailbroken PS4s. However, it's super simple and easy to set up compared to those other methods. So this will only work with games that support LAN play, which is the ability to play with multiple PS4s connected on the same network without PSN or anything like that. And the way it works is that even though you and your buddies are on different internet connections, you all connect to a Hamachi network, which is essentially like a VPN network, so that you appear as though you're on the same local network to the PS4, and it will allow you to connect to each other over the internet. So that's essentially how this works. So of course, not all games support LAN play. There is a list here over on lan-play.com, which is another service for being able to play online using the same methods. I may cover it in another video, but this shows a bunch of PS4 games that are supported that have a LAN play option. So you've got Borderlands, you've got most of the Call of Duty games all support LAN play. You have Diablo, Dying Light. You've also got Rainbow Six Siege, and of course Saints Row as well, and a few others. So I'm not sure if this is a complete list. There may be more, but there's a few games there that support LAN play that you can do this with. So switching back over to the console, the way that I've got this set up is I'm currently hosting a LAN play game here on my jailbroken PS4. This is my 9.00 PS4. As you can see right here, if you take note of the IP address, 192.168.1.37. So I'm hosting a game there. I also have another PS4 set up here that's on 6.72 firmware. And you can see the IP address is completely different. It's not within the same IP address range. So 192.168.43.195. So these PS4s are on separate internet connections, so they will not be able to find each other on LAN play without Hamachi. So for example here, if I head back into Modern Warfare, and if I go back to Modern Warfare here on this PS4, so I'm hosting the game here on my 9.00 PS4, and then on the 6.72 PS4, you can see that the game is not showing up right here, and that is because these two PS4s are on completely separate internet connections. So hopefully by the end of the video, once we have everything set up, we should be able to connect these two PS4s together and find each other's games, even though they are on separate internet connections. So let's dive right in here to the setup process. So switching back over to the computer, you're going to need to download the Hamachi Homebrew app. So download the package file here on Sleirsgoevy's GitHub page, which will be linked in the video description. And then from there, of course, we're just going to copy that over to the root of our USB drive. So I've got a USB drive here. I'm going to copy the package file to the root of the drive. Don't put it inside any existing folders. And then obviously make sure the USB drive is formatted in exFAT format or FAT32 format. From there, we can then go ahead and eject the drive and plug it back into our PS4. Okay, so on the PS4, I'm just going to go ahead and close out of Modern Warfare. And of course, head onto the internet browser and load your exploit page, whichever one you normally use. Currently using kmepsfour.site, or you can use caro218.ir, but apparently it's down at the moment, so that link might change. So right now I'm using kmepsfour.site. I'm using one of the manual hosts, and you want to just run the gold hen payload to jailbreak the PS4. Once you've got the PS4 jailbroken, we're then going to head on to settings. We're going to go to gold hen and then go to package installer, or you can go to the debug settings and go to game package installer, and then we're going to select our Hamachi app and install it directly to the PS4. If you've already had Hamachi installed in the past and you couldn't get it to work, and every time you launch it, you get some kind of error, then just delete it and reinstall a fresh version. So from here, we're going to run log me in Hamachi, and it's going to launch the daemon. Obviously, you want to make sure you're connected to the internet when you do this. And we are logging in. So when you first launch it here, it says you're not in any networks. If you want to be the host of the network, if you want to create a network, you just hit triangle to create your network and then enter a network name. So make sure it's a unique name that's unlikely to already be taken, because if you've got a duplicate network name to some other network that's already been created, it will not allow you to create that network. So we're going to go ahead and just call this one MW2019 and we'll do PS4. I don't know if that's going to be a unique enough name. And then you can also enter a password. If you only want to allow certain people into your network, then you should set a password. If you want to give anybody access to the network, then just leave the password blank and then anybody can connect to it as long as they know what the network name is. So we're just going to go ahead and not bother entering a password there. And we've now created the network. So from there, I'm just going to press the PS button on the PS4 controller and then go over and launch the game. So another thing that's important is you need to make sure that the game versions match. So for example, you can see this version of Modern Warfare is on version 1.01. So whoever I'm trying to connect to or whoever's trying to connect to me, they need to make sure that their game version is the same as mine. If they're on a different game version, we will not be able to see each other's games. So that's very important. Just like when you connect to PSN and you try to go on multiplayer, it's going to say that you need to update to the latest version if you're not already on the latest version to make sure that everybody's on the same game version. So unfortunately, there's no automatic check with LAN play. So what you need to do is just make sure yourself, just double check that you're all on the correct game version so that you can connect to each other. So from here, we're going to run the game Modern Warfare. We're going to log in here. It's going to try and connect to online services, which it's not going to be able to do, of course, because we're on a jailbroken PS4. On an older firmware. So it says connection failed. We're going to go to go offline and then select multiplayer. And then I'm going to press triangle to create a new multiplayer match. So I'm now creating this LAN play, which is being broadcast over the Hamachi network. So if we switch over to the other PS4 here, which obviously is not running Hamachi right now, so it can't see the network. So we're going to go ahead again, close the application. I just recommend running Hamachi, connecting to the network and then launching the game. Rather than having the game already running and then launching Hamachi, might not make much of a difference, not sure. But anyway, I've already got Hamachi installed on this other PS4 as well. So we're going to launch this. Okay, we are launching Daemon. Now, by the way, if you get an error message that looks something like this, I recommend just always having Hamachi on a USB drive or something, because that way you can just delete the app and reinstall it, and that should sort of refresh it properly. Otherwise, you have to like reboot the PS4. To refresh it, which is kind of annoying because then you have to run the jailbreak again. So if you do run into an error message like that, just reinstall the app rather than having to reboot, and then you'll be able to, you know, get it working again. So as you can see with this PS4, we're not currently in any networks. So rather than creating a network this time, we're going to connect to the network that we already made on the other PS4. So we're going to press square to connect to the network and then enter that same network name, which was MW2019 and then PS4. And of course, I never entered a password for the network, so I'm just going to not enter anything here for the password and it will connect me. There we go, joining, and we're now connected to that network. So now again, I can press the PS button on the controller and launch the game. Okay, so connection failed. We're going to go to go offline. We'll go to multiplayer and boom, there you go. You can see the game is showing up there already. So Modern Warfare on Hackney Yard. Let's join it. And there we go. We successfully joined session. You can see there's me on the second 6.72 PS4 and I'm connected to the game that's been hosted by the other PS4 that's on 9.00 on completely separate internet connections, because as you could plainly see before, without Hamachi, they could not find each other. So these two PS4s were not connected to the same network. However, they have been able to find each other and join the game here just fine using Hamachi. So let's go ahead and start the match and we'll get into the game here and make sure it's all going to load up successfully. Okay, so you can see here we've loaded up. Let's switch over to the other PS4 since it's higher resolution, and we'll go ahead and open this up so you can see both players are added to the game here and we are playing technically online because they're on separate internet connections. Okay, so now let me go over some of the issues that you might run into trying to get this to work. So firstly, obviously, there's the issue of crashing the Hamachi service. When you launch the app, you get that warning that says it couldn't start the daemon or something like that. If that happens, then you should just delete the app and reinstall it, or reboot the PS4, relaunch the jailbreak and run the app again. Either one of those should fix that issue. So the other issue is obviously not finding other people in game, not being able to find their matches or not being able to join their matches when you try to join them. So this can happen due to a number of different reasons. As I've already explained, you want to make sure that you're on the correct game version. Everybody's in the same game version, otherwise you won't be able to see each other's matches. And another thing that you need to watch out for as well is you want to make sure that the PS4 is connecting directly to your router, directly to your network, and not going through another device to connect to the internet, like, you know, using connection sharing on your computer to share your computer's connection with the PS4. You don't want to use that kind of setup for this. You want it connected directly to your router if possible through Wi-Fi or Ethernet, and then you'll have a better chance of success. And then another thing as well is that port forwarding might be required. I haven't needed to use port forwarding. It's worked fine for me without it, but it's possible that you might require to forward your ports because sometimes your router might have a firewall that's blocking the port that Hamachi is trying to use. And that's why you can't see anybody's games or host a game and get anybody to join if your router is blocking it. So I'll give you a brief port forwarding guide here, just to show you how to fix that if that is a problem. Hopefully it won't be. For most people it should work without having to port forward, but there might be some people out there that need to do this. So if I switch over to the computer, I can't just do a guide on how to port forward for everybody because everybody has different routers, different models, different brands, and they all have different ways of setting up port forwarding. So what I recommend doing if you've not port forwarded before is head to the website portforward.com, which I'll link in the video description. From here, this can give you a lot of useful information. So for example, to find the port we're looking for, we can just search for Hamachi in portforward.com. And I believe it's Hamachi 2 that we're looking for here. So we're going to select Hamachi 2. And this will give you the ports that you need to forward. So we've got two ports for TCP, 12975 and 32976. And one port for UDP, which is 17771. So now that we have the ports, we can then go to the router list. So we can click here for list of routers, or we can go to routers up here and select list of routers. I'll open that up in a new tab. And this will give me all the different brands of routers. So I can just find the brand that my router uses. So mine is a Fritzbox. So I'm going to select Fritzbox. You select your router, and then it will give you all the different models of that type of router. So my model doesn't actually show up in here, but I can just select one that is, you know, close to it, like this one, 7490. So I'll select that model. And then this gives me a detailed guide on how to forward the ports on my particular router. So you can see it gives you the default gateway. It also gives you the default username and password for the router, or it'll tell you where to find it if it's like on a sticker on the router itself, so you can log in. And then it gives you the detailed steps with screenshots showing you what sections you need to go to on the router and how to set up port forwarding. So it gives you all the information right there. So first thing you need to do is find the default gateway. So if I go on command prompt and type in ipconfig, so give me all the network adapters IP addresses. So here's my wireless adapter that I'm using to connect to the internet. And you can see the default gateway is 192.168.1.1. So you just head to that address there on your internet browser, your default gateway, and then that will take you to your router's login page. You log in, and once I've logged in, I'll go to the port forwarding section that I need to go to, which is permit access down here, and then port sharing. And then from there, I'm going to add a device for sharing. And then I'm going to select the PS4 from the list of networks, which is this one here. Even though this shows up as like a Linux distro, that's because I was running that Linux distro on the PS4 when it connected to the network, so it's assigned it that name, but that actually is the PS4, as you can see, 192.168.1.37. And if you have a look here, you can see that that is the correct IP address for the PS4, so we've got the correct device. So we select the device we want to forward the ports for, which is the PS4, and then I'm going to click new sharing, and then I'm going to select the application. I'm just going to select other application. I'm going to call it Hamachi, and then select TCP, and then enter the port numbers. So this one, 12975 was the first port. So I'm going to enter that 12975, click OK, and that will add it. And then I'll do another new sharing. Same thing again, other application, Hamachi, and this will be another TCP port. And this one is our 32976 port. So I'll enter that port in there to forward, and click OK. And then finally, one last one, new sharing, other application, name Hamachi, and protocol is going to be UDP this time because we have this UDP port 17771. So we're going to go ahead and enter that and click OK. And there we go. So that's everything set up. I can just click OK here. And there we go. You can see that's now set up. So we are now port forwarding the Hamachi ports to my PS4's IP address. It's also recommended to set up a static IP address for the PS4 if you do require port forwarding, because that way the IP address isn't going to change and the ports will remain open. Whereas if you use DHCP, which is an automatic IP address, then it can change every now and then. And if it changes, then of course it's not going to be forwarded anymore. So it's a good idea to set up a static IP address if you can. Again, I recommend using portforward.com because it can tell you what the ports are for Hamachi, and it will also show you a step-by-step guide for your router on how to set up port forwarding, because every router is very different because of all the different brands and models that are out there. This is currently the easiest method to set up to be able to connect to other people. Now, hopefully there's going to be an even better solution coming soon from DizRL and DeathRGH, who are working on reviving the COD LAN payload or COD Online payload to work with other games that support LAN play and revive it for the latest firmwares and stuff. So that'll be great when that comes out, because that should be an even easier setup than this. And it should also allow us to connect to more people online and find more people online, which would be, you know, awesome if that comes out soon. But in the meantime, you've got Hamachi that you can use, and you also have excellent Kai and XBS Link, which I already have tutorials for. If you want me to cover LAN play, which is the only one I haven't covered so far for the PS4, then let me know down in the comments below. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video or found the information useful. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe, and I'll hopefully see you guys in the next video.